In today's class, let us revise the poem Benjamin Jones Goes Swimming, written by Eileen Lucia Fisher, famously known as Eileen Fisher. Okay, she's an American writer, born on 9th September 1906 and died on 2nd December 2002. And she has written hundreds of children's books, poetry, picture books in verse, prose about nature and America, biographies, Bible themed books, plays and articles. Also she has written for magazines and journals. Okay, and she has received many prestigious awards for her enormous contribution to the field of literature. Okay, and this poem Benjamin Jones Goes Swimming is a poem which describes an incident in a humorous manner. It tells the story of Benjamin, who participated in a swimming competition, and he was not a good swimmer. Still, he wanted to try and win. Did he win the prize at the end? Let's see. Okay, so this poem is a humorous poem written by Eileen Lucia Fisher, which tells us about a person. The main character of this poem, Benjamin Jones, wanted to participate in the swimming competition, but his wife wanted to stop him to participate in this competition because of some reason. So what is that reason? Let us see in this poem again. I know you already know the reason behind it. Did he win the prize at the end? Let us see. Okay, now I'm going to read the poem. You have to listen well. Okay. Benjamin Jones, in confident tones, told his wife on the 4th of July, "I think I will compete in the free-for-all meet. I bet I can win if I try." But his wife said, "My word, how very absurd. You haven't gone swimming for years. With others so fast, you are sure to be last, and I will blush to the tip of my ears." Well, the fourth quickly came, and waiting acclaim, were wonderful swimmers galore. Each poised in his place for the start of the race, while spectators crowded the shore. The contest began, and Benji, poor man, was passed on the left and the right. His pace was so slow that a crab saw his toe and thought it would venture a bite. Ben noticed the crab as it started to grab, and perhaps the result can be guessed. The thought of his toe in the claw of his foe made him swim like a swimmer possessed. And the crowd on the shore sent up a great roar as Ben took the lead in the dash, while his wife on the dock received such a shock. She fell in the lake with a splash, written by Eileen Fisher or Eileen Lucia Fisher. Benjamin Jones, in confident tones, told to his wife, what did he say? "On the 4th of July, I think I will compete in the free-for-all meet." Compete means here going to participate in the free-for-all meet, and he was very confident about that. Confident means here sure. He was very sure, and free-for-all meet means anyone can participate in that competition. Okay, so he told his wife that on 4th of July, okay, on 4th of July, I think I will compete on that. Means I am going to participate in the free-for-all swimming competition. Who said this? Benjamin Jones to his wife, very confident and very sure about his decision. "I bet I can win if I try," and his wife was so confident that he said, "I bet I can win this competition if I try hard." Who said this? Benjamin Jones. But his wife said, "My word, how very absurd." Absurd means here foolish. Absurd means foolish. And she thought that it is very foolish that his husband is going and participating in the free-for-all swimming competition. Why? She said, "You haven't gone swimming for years. With others so fast, you are sure to be last, and I will blush to the tip of my ears." You haven't gone swimming, you have no practice, so that you can go and other competitors or the other swimmers, the trained swimmers will be there and they will swim so fast and you will left behind. And by seeing you come last, I will blush. Here, blush means you feel shy. Okay. His wife said that I will feel shy if you come last in the swimming competition. Who said this? Benjamin Johnson. Why said this? And she said, you haven't gone swimming for years. You have no practice. So how can you go and participate in such a competition? Okay, and I will blush to the tip of my ears. I can't see that, she said. Well, the fourth wicket came and waiting and claim were wonderful swimmers galore. Here, the fourth wicket came and waiting acclaim. Here, acclaim means praise. Acclaim means praise. There were many number of people gathered together to watch this competition, the free-for-all swimming competition. Okay, the 4th of July quickly came. 4th of July means the competition day. And the people, those who were gathered together there to watch this competition, they were praising each and every competitor there, okay. And competitors, each poised in his place for the start of the race. Here, poised means stood ready. Each of the competitor, they were standing over there, they were ready for the competition, while spectators crowded the shore. Here, spectators means onlookers, the audience, okay, the people, those who came there to watch that competition, they were praising everyone, they were screaming, they were very excited to watch that particular swimming competition here, okay. They were crowded on the shore, the side of the lake, okay. The contest began. Contest means here, the competition, okay. The contest, which competition? The swimming competition, it began. And Benji, Benji means here the main character of this poem, Benjamin Jones, okay. So Benji, the poor man, was passed on the left and the right. Means the competition already begun. And Benji, the poor fellow, he also started to swim, but was passed on the left and the right. That means here, the other swimmers, other contestants, so they passed on his right and the left. That means he was swimming so slowly that other contestants, as his wife said, they started to swim faster than Benji here. Okay, so on 4th of July, the swimming competition, that also free for all meet, was about to begin. And by that time, here Benjamin Jones, he wanted to participate. He decided actually to participate in the free for all meet and informed his wife that he's going to participate in the competition. But his wife was not at all happy by hearing these words, because he haven't gone swimming for years and he have no practice and all those things. So his wife discouraged him not to participate at all. But finally, as he decided, the 4th of July came and here Benji went there to participate in the competition, his wife too. And the competition began and he started to swim, but many other swimmers, they passed him so faster from his left and the right side. His pace was so slow that a crab saw his toe and thought it would venture a bite. Here, pace means speed. His speed was so slow that a crab saw his toe while swimming. Whose toe? Benjamin Jones' toe, and thought it would venture a bite. Venture a bite means to try to bite. It thought that it's some kind of food and also that's why it thought to bite his toe. Okay. Here pace means speed. He was swimming so slowly. That's why. Ben noticed the crab as it started to grab, and perhaps the result can be guessed. And he was swimming so slowly that he noticed that crab, and the crab perhaps means it's going to bite his toe. He saw that, and perhaps the result can be guessed here. Grab means catch hold of, okay, catch hold of his toe, and he understood what is going to happen with him. He guessed the result, okay. The thought of his toe in the claw of his foe made him swim like a swimmer possessed. The thought of going to catch hold of me, okay, and my toe, claw of his foe. He thought that his toe in the claw of his foe. Foe means here enemy, the crab, okay, made him swim like a swimmer possessed. That thought, when it came into his mind, he started to swim like a swimmer possessed. A swimmer possessed means here like a trained swimmer, he started to swim. Only by thinking that this crab is going to bite my toe, this crab, my enemy, foe means here enemy, okay. So this crab is going to bite my toe, and by thinking, that single thought made him to swim so faster like a trained swimmer, okay. And the crowd on the shore sent up a great roar. By seeing this, that means suddenly the Benjamin Jones started to swim so faster and left behind other trained swimmers. By seeing this, the people, those who are gathered on the shore of the lake, they gave a great roar, means the sound, in full of happiness they roared once, means they take up a happy sound, okay. As Ben took the lead in the dash, means Ben means here Benjamin Jones came first, okay. He won the swimming competition while his wife and the dog received such a shock. By seeing this, his wife, Benjamin Jones' wife, got a shock that her husband won the competition. By seeing all these things, she fell in the lake with the splash. Here, dash means hurry. In a hurry, he swam and swam very fast and won the competition. Here, and splash means a sound made by something striking or falling into liquid. As he fell, she fell into the water splashed, okay, water splashed. So because, only because of the shock she got, as her husband won the swimming competition, and he, how he won that competition, only because of that crab, okay. The crab made him to swim so fastly, and because of that crab only he won the competition. That fear made him to swim so faster, and because of that reason only he won the competition. And by seeing this, his wife got a shock and she fell into the water with a splash in the water. So this is such a humorous poem written by Eileen Lucia Fisher, okay. Very humorously, funnily, she has written this beautiful poem in which the main character Benjamin Jones won the swimming competition in a very humorous way, only because of that crab, actually, on 4th of July, children. So now let us move on to some questions here. Okay, your first question is, swimming meet took place on 5th of July, 7th of July or 4th of July? When the swimming meet took place on? On 4th of July. Okay, and your second question is, the swimming competition was a dash. Absolute meet, river all meet or acclaimed competition? What's the answer for this question? The swimming competition was a free for all meet. Okay, children.